Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video, guys, to any of you having a Ford vehicle. It could be any Ford, guys. It could be Ford Focus, Fiesta, Fusion, C-Max, Escape, Explorer, Edge, F-150. Doesn't matter what it is. If you guys have electric vacuum pump, and many new engines will have that, we'll explain how you can test it, guys, and find out if it's working or not. If your pump doesn't work, okay, you may have multiple codes, but also you may have hard brake paddle, because especially on hybrid vehicles, most of them will have electric vacuum pump, because when the engine is not working, you have no vacuum. No vacuum means the brake booster will not work correctly, and you will have hard brake paddle, and you will lose your braking ability on your vehicle as well. So all that will be covered in this video today. You will not even get your hands dirty. It will be super easy test. Before we start, let me just tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission as a shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video. That way we can keep making these absolutely free videos for you. If you guys need to buy any parts, tools for a good price and quick shipping, check out, guys, the link in the description of the video below. That's where you can get all the tools, parts from. That's where we get ours from. And you can save yourself, guys, quite a bit of money. So, what we can do here now, okay, pretty easily, we're going to go inside, okay? And you need to find the OBD port. I have the scanner connected, but let me disconnect it and show you now. The OBD port is usually under the dash on your Ford vehicle, or you may have a cover that says OBD. Open it, and right here, that's where it is. The scanner that we are using, guys, okay, it's the Think2. I will put the link in the description of the video below. This is amazing one. I will put exactly which version it is. But this scanner, guys, it's like a dealer level equipment for your phone. Turns your phone into a super powerful computer that can even program engine computers, modules, and things like that. All we have to do, plug it in. It's very inexpensive as well, and it can pay itself off practically in one time use. I will go ahead, turn the ignition switch on, just like that. And once you do that, guys, okay, let's go ahead and see what we're going to do now. We'll click all system diagnostics. Here, we'll click VIN number. Okay, it's going to decode the VIN number. Okay, and let's see, okay, if it's going to work now, guys. Okay, if it's going to read it, decode it, and find out, okay, what is actually happening there. So, for C-Max 2013 model, so it's going to do that now. It will take just a little bit of time. We need to confirm that the ignition switch is on. Okay, let's do that. And then, guys, okay, it will communicate with all the different computers as well. Okay, so once it does that, okay, you need to select system selection here, and you will see you may have up to 50 computers on your Ford vehicle. They're so complicated nowadays. Even though it's Ford, it's all Mercedes, BMWs, Volkswagen. They're the ones usually that have the most computers. Ford, okay, has quite a few different systems. Now, they may not have too many modules, but they have different systems that communicate with each other. We need to select anti-locking brake. Here we'll go to actuation test, and under actuation test you will be able to find vacuum pump, guys. So let's see. Okay, vacuum pump status. Okay, and you can load data stream, and you can actually even check the vacuum in the lines. I believe vacuum pressure right here, vacuum pump test status. Let me select those. Okay, the vacuum pressure is negative 10 psi. I can go ahead, let me come outside now. Let me come outside. And what I can do, that pump is located by the booster right there in the back. We can go ahead and activate it, guys. Okay, and that pump is all the way in the back. I kind of like see where it's located, where the brake lines are going. You can see directly right there behind the dash. So when I turn it on now, okay, listen now, you hear it working. Excuse me, that's the brake pump. Vacuum pump will be right here. Listen now. And the pressure will go down. It should stay, if you don't have vacuum leaks, that pressure will stay at around about that same number, guys, until, okay,
you let it sit for a while, but if everything's good, you don't have vacuum leaks, you should have steady pressure. It will pump up, you'll go to negative 12 psi almost, and vacuum pump on again. You can see we can build pressure, but it stays pretty steady. So definitely, guys, good working pump in our case. You can see it may go even up, but it's important when it turns off to stay about the same and doesn't drop fast. But you can see the pump activates and pumps pressure, guys. So definitely working. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to find this. Thank you for watching. See you next time.